when they judge it, they look for three things, right? Use of colour, overall sense of design, and the aspect of the building. They take that into account as well. So although Sandhill's north-facing, that doesn't matter so much.
And you reckon it's easy?
Well, it is at this time of year because there's not a lot to do.
No, I mean, generally not.
Generally, if you give it a bit of thought, pick the right plants, take your time, you can't go far wrong. Afternoon, sir. Just go through, ring the bell, wait for the buzzer.
It makes a difference, though, doesn't it?
Hell of a difference, Rich. People love it.
Now, say those little ones at the front, what are they called?
Oh, these? Mm. They're Viola tricolor.
Lovely. Have they got an English one?
Winter pansies.
Right, ladies and gentlemen, unless anyone's got anything else to offer.
Yeah, well, sir, there was one thing, just while everyone's got it. I've been thinking.
Go on.
Well, sir, the front of the station, you know, the forecourt and everything, is the building intimidating or is it me?
It's you.
No, look, seriously, imagine you're a member of the public.
Imagine you're a human being.
It's a police station, Reg. What's it meant to look like?
Well, something I think that would help a lot is a station garden.
He's been talking to Yates at Stafford Row.
Yeah, comparing anoraks.
We've already got a garden, Ridge.
Well, no, Sarge, with respect, what we've got is a couple of trees and a few shrubs. I just wondered if anyone would object to me tidying it up a bit.
You can come round and do my garden if you're that desperate.
You know, a few plants, introduce a bit of colour.
What, in the middle of winter?
Well, you've got your Viola tricolor. They are very nice at this time of the year. Then you've got your Hepatica nobilis.
The Hollis stupidicus?
No, look, just something, you know, to make the place seem a bit more welcoming.
Welcoming?
Well, not just to members of the public, but to us lot as well. Well, what do people think?
I don't think we care, Ridge.
I think it's a great idea. I get hay fever.
Yeah, well, look, I'll tell you, it also would help us boost our community policing as well.
There's only one sure way of doing that, and that's by being out there. Thank you, everyone.
It's all right for you lot. I'm stuck with him for the rest of the day.
Tony, hang about.
Sorry, the station garden. Do you think it would be worth running by Mr. Conway?
You could do, I suppose, when you've thought it through.
Oh, I've got it all sorted out, sir. All I need now is the go-ahead. Perhaps if I popped up there and called him now?
Don't make it last all day.
It does look a bit boring, you know. A few flowers might brighten it up.
Oh, yeah. Some little gnomes and a fairy grotto.
517 from Sierra Oscar, receiving?
Hey, George.
Yeah, we've had a call about an abandoned vehicle in the derelict factory on Elcott Street. Can you deal?
I'm right.
As I said, Reg, he's still at lunch at the moment. This afternoon, well, I'll have a look, but I really don't think that...
I was just hoping to do something with the station garden. Oh, so you've got a bit of greenery in here? Oh, it does make a difference, doesn't it?
Don't touch it.
What makes the place seem a bit more human? You know, lived in. Well, less like an office room. Oh, sir. Stroke of luck.
There's a scavenger's flying over a wing mirror.
Totally pit clean.
Anyone see how it got here?
Sierra Oscar from 358 receiving.
Go ahead, Gary.
Yeah, George, about that car left in the derelict factory. It's a dark blue Porsche 911. Or what's left of a Porsche 911. Registration number. Registration number, Juliet 543, Yankee Whiskey, November.
I didn't know you took an interest in gardening.
Oh, me, sir? Yeah, well, I understand the basics. You know, use of colour, overall sense of design, that sort of thing.
Basics?
Oh, yes, sir. And PC Yates over at Stafford Row said he'd give me any advice, should I need it.
Can he afford a rival in the Met Garden competition?
Oh, it wouldn't be a threat to him, sir. No, no. See, we'd be entered under different categories. He's got a Class B garden.
Yes, well, don't worry about trophies just yet, Reg.
Oh, no, sir. Mind you, even an honorary mention would help raise our profile in the area. And with all this talk of amalgamation, I mean...
Well, I don't think a herbaceous board is going to make much difference to that, do you?
Sir, can I just tell you what I've got in my mind? I was thinking of some training plants, perhaps a couple of shrubs, and then over side of the front office you can get these tubs, yeah. And they really...
Slow down, Reg, slow down. This is starting to sound a bit ambitious.
Oh, is it so? Well, it's not really.
And expensive. There's no money in the kitty, you do know that, don't you?
Yes, I do, sir. But look, PC Yates found that the local nurseries were very pleased to contribute.
Well, let's just concentrate on picking up the crisp packets and the Coke cans before we get into the hanging gardens of Sun Hill, shall we?
Yes, sir.
Still here, Tony?
Just wait for Rich, sir. Sorry, sir. I was upstairs talking to Mr. Conway. He got right into the station garden idea. Wanted to talk about what was in my mind.
I'm surprised it took so long.
Yeah, of course, there is only one small problem. There's no money in the kitty, but, I can work around it.
Are you going to mump it all?
I didn't hear that. Whatever you do with this garden is strictly off duty. I don't want you tiptoeing through the tulips when you should be pounding the beet.
Yeah, no, of course not.
Well, go on, then.
Well, ready when Tony is.
See, Oscar from 358 receiving.
Yeah, go ahead.
Yeah, there's not a lot we can do here, George. Could you notify the registered keeper so we can arrange for it to be picked up?
Well, it's not drivable.
Nah, it's definitely not drivable. Break it to him gently. In the meantime, we're going to find someone with half a ton of Porsche spares.
If Reg is prepared to give up his free time to improve the look of the station, I feel reluctant to stop him.
It's certainly difficult to criticise him for enthusiasm.
Incapability Hollis.
Good afternoon, gentlemen.
Hello again, Mr. Marley.
Come to give me this week's hard time.
Oh, just doing the rounds.
I haven't been trying to flog any Porsche spares.
Bit posh for us, a Porsche.
Couple of MOT failures came in, that's all. What's that, your shopping list?
No, just this week's victims of car crimes and their VINs.
Oh, come on then, but you won't find anything.
Well, too well hidden. Mr. Marley, say you were a thief and you got hold of an engine or a gearbox for a Porsche, where would you get rid of it?
If I was a thief?
Hypothetically.
Hypothetically? Well, I'd try here first. And this being a respectable, law-abiding establishment, I'd be turned away, maybe even turned in.
We're a pain in the backside, you know that.
Look, it won't take a minute. I'll be straight in and I'll be straight out again.
Munro will go spare.
Look, Tony, come on. It's not just for me, you know. It's for the benefit of everyone at Sun Hill. Oh, these are lovely, aren't they? One on the side of the front office would be nice.
Yeah, lovely. They last about a night before someone has them away.
Yeah, I'll see if I can locate the manager.
Okay, two beds, north facing. What kind of soil have you got?
Upwell.
I mean, is it heavy? Has it got any clay in it?
Ah, well, it's quite dry.
Don't worry about it. Ah, now a Cotoneaster. That should be all right. Or we could go with a Pyracantha, and then you could train that a little bit.
Oh, yeah.
Be careful.
Yeah, I'll have one of them.
The Pyracantha.
Mm.
Okay, so we'll add that to the six trays of Viola tricolor, the dwarf conifers, the odds and sods, the tubs. Is that the lot?
Yeah, I better not get too carried away.
Well, you've got about 150 quid's worth here.
Oh, dear. Is it really as much as that?
Well, the tubs are top of the range.
Oh, yeah, well, quite exactly. Any chance of a, you know...
You want a discount?
Oh, yeah. Well, 100% would be handy. Well, as you know, we are seriously underfunded in the Met.
Uh-huh.
And I'm working to a very tight budget.
How tight?
Well, of course, the other thing is, cops are always looking for somewhere to shop. It's been generous to them, showing a bit of community spirit.
And this might be a way of increasing my turnover.
How'd you get on?
Oh, smashing. Yeah, I sorted some things out. Shrubs and tubs, you know, having them delivered tomorrow.
How much it cost you? How much?
Well, I mumped it, didn't I?
Yeah?
Well, everyone else does.
It didn't cost you anything. Not a penny.
Look, I gave him the old sob story, all right? You know, about the budget. He's quite a nice bloke, actually. Wait, do you want to go through my pockets for a receipt?
You say you mumped it, you mumped it. Check out the stereo.
What's it, dodgy? Nice bit of kit.
Everything all right?
It's your car, sir.
We're sure we get out of it.
You are?
Frankly, Andy Frankly.
Just admiring your stereo.
Oh, what did I have it up to, lad? Sorry about that.
They're your eardrums, mate. No, what it is we're running routine checks on expensive stereos fitting into older cars.
Yeah, it's an initiative we got going, you know, following car theft.
Oh, what, seeing if they're nicked? Well, it makes sense.
Mind if I ask where you got your stereo?
Well, it's not stolen.
It really is only a routine inquiry.
I got it off my brother-in-law.
How much do you want for it?
80 quid.
It's not bad. Do you like to go for retail?
I think you paid 200, 220 for it.
It's a nice little bargain.
Where'd he get it?
Somewhere local, I think. I'm not sure.
What, a shop?
Well, let's put it this way. I hope it was a shop and not some car park.
I don't suppose you know the serial number offhand.
No.
He stamped on the side of the unit.
Right, if we take it out, have a look.
Well, you're going to need a couple of spanners, only it's in there pretty securely. I don't want anyone nicking it.
Haven't you got any?
Not on me, no.
Then ask your mate's got a couple of spanners. The manager.
Oh, I think he's busy with a delivery.
Look, Sunil's on my way home. Why don't you follow me back there, or I'll follow you back or something? Well, it's only going to take a couple of minutes, isn't it?
As long as there's nothing wrong with it.
Well, coming in.
OK, we'll follow you.
All right.
Here, we calling his bluff?
Well, as long as Munro doesn't find out where we've been, it doesn't really matter.
I'm pretty sure there's a serial number in it. Look, what's going to happen if there isn't?
Well, do we want to talk to your brother now?
Well, as far as I know, I think he bought it.
Yeah, not long ago, right?
About 2 months before he lost his licence for drink driving.
Hey.
Well, there's no point in keeping a car you can't drive. And my sister wanted to stick with her one, so he sold it. Well, he took the stereo out first, though.
Well, couldn't he have fitted it in her car?
Well, she didn't want to give anyone reason to break into it.
And that didn't bother you?
Well, she's got this nice new shiny Metro. And I figured that if anyone's after a flash stereo, they're hardly going to look in this thing, aren't they?
Still goes, all right.
Well, it should do. I've just had a new engine put in it.
Wait, that was painful.
Well, I say new, I mean reconditioned.
How much you pay for it?
Well, I'm not sure how much the engine was exactly, but with oil and stuff, bits and pieces, and the labour, it came out at 150 quid. That's for cash.
It's a bit of bargain in the stereo.
Well, it's not bad. I mean, a new engine for one of those, I think they wanted nearly a grand. I mean, it's more than the car's worth. But I've got this mechanic who's really good, so...
Oh, sir. This is Mr. Franklin. He's very kindly brought his car in so we can check the serial number on the stereo.
If you ever get the damn thing out.
I only went down the garden centre for a ball of string.
Excuse us a moment, Mr. Franklin.
Well, sir, we were checking car parks. We did a couple of the superstores on the Linefield Walk and...
What did I say to you?
Yeah, I know, sir. We're only trying to be methodical.
Reg, don't push your luck.
At last. And the good news is it has got a number. Take this down, Reg.
Right.
BJB 62116.
Got it.
Right, now what are you going to do?
Well, I see it's on our computer.
And if it's not?
Well, thank you for your time. But just before we do that, you mind if I have a look under the bonnet?
No.
All right. Tony, call me, please. Wow, was a cheap engine.
Yeah?
Yeah. I was wondering if it was a bit too cheap.
But haven't we just been through this about the stereo?
Hmm. Yeah. Tony, it's not right, is it?
Nah.
What's not right?
You've seen this?
Yeah.
Basically, most engines fitted in a car will give them their own identification number. Their VIN. Most are embossed onto the block. Very difficult to get rid of. On some French cars, though, the number's printed on a plate, only stuck on. The problem with this plate is, it really is only stuck on.
What, should it have been welded or something?
Riveted, actually.
Problem is, it's an offence to alter a VIN.
But it hasn't been altered. I mean, this is a replacement engine. And if you do a straight swap, you carry the numbers over.
Who told you that?
The mechanic.
And give us this mechanic's name.
Sewell.
Peter Saul. He's got a workshop on Relco Street. He does all the work on my car. I mean, he gives it a service, gets it through its MOT. And then when the engine blew up, I gave him a ring. I mean, I thought he was all right, you know, a good bloke.
Did he tell you where he got it from?
I think he said he got lucky down one of the scrapyards.
Yeah, very lucky.
Well, I mean, I didn't know. I was just grateful that he fixed it. I mean, you don't expect an engine to be stolen. Well, I don't.
Even when the identification numbers changed?
But he said you could do that. He said you could swap them over.
Oh, Mike, you've been doing the rounds. Have you heard of a mechanic called Peter Saul?
Oh, what's he done?
Oh, he's fitted a new engine in a Peugeot.
Well, did it come from a Porsche? There's one knocking around out there somewhere.
Oh, yeah. Now, he might have got a good deal at my local baker's, yeah.
And Marley's?
Oh, that would be nice, wouldn't it? All down to the simple routine procedure of checking stereos in cars.
Has the engine still got a number on it?
Yeah, but not the original one.
Oh, then you're stuffed. Can't be traced. You're better off sticking to your garden.
Another waste of time, eh?
Oh, did I say that, Reg? A few flowers is just what we need at Sunhill. Yeah, and I tell you, you won't have any problem getting them to grow, not with all the horse manure that comes out your mouth.
See, your garden's having its desired soothing effect on the station, Reg.
So I'll keep the car, then?
Well, we don't in our yard.
And only rust and the pound up in Chalk Farm, so you might as well take it with you.
Oh, cheers.
Don't sell it, or you'll be committing theft. And don't crash it, or we'll be very annoyed.
Well, is there anything I should do?
Yeah, read your registration documents.
No, sir. Nothing on Saul.
See, like I told you, I mean, he seems like a really nice bloke.
We'll bear that in mind.
Peter Saul?
Hang on a sec. Better than it was.
It's about a customer of yours, Andy Franklin.
Remind me.
Peugeot 309, off-white, E-Ridge.
What about him?
You fitted a new engine in it for him.
Yeah, I think I did.
Won't you tell us anything about it?
Like what?
Well, where you got it, how much you charged in for it.
Don't know. What's the problem then? Packed up on him?
No, it still works all right. We just want to know where you got it.
There was an ad in one of the trades. Some bloke was breaking a Peugeot up the other side of Greenwich.
Well, do you know his name, address?
Sorry, I don't.
How much you pay for it?
Look, this was a while ago, you know.
Well, no, it was only 3 months.
Yeah, but I'm always buying bits and pieces from people.
You got a record of it?
No, it was a cash job. I don't think I put it through the books, you know.
Does anything go through the books?
Some things do, yeah.
Have you got any books? What's under there then?
Oh, that's just scrap waiting to be picked up.
Scrap. What's this from? Not Peugeot, I know that much. Something pretty big and sporty.
It's a Porsche 911.
Someone's had a pretty good go at grinding the ID number off.
Do you want to change out your overalls? Wash your hands. I think you're going to be down the station for some time.
Sir, there's some blokes unloading a van in the yard. I thought you might like to know.
It's all right, Andrew. Run away to a stabbing.
What's going on now?
Come on, let's have you.
Come on, mate.
Oh, damn. Look, be careful with those, Mike.
Sure, miss. You should be clearing it up.
Here, Reg, he's committing shrubbery with violence.
Oh, yeah. Oh, look, these are expensive, you know.
You better have a word with the DCI, Reg.
Yeah.
This wasn't supposed to happen, was it, Reg?
No, it wasn't actually, sir. I'd asked for these to be delivered tomorrow lunchtime. I was going to deal with it before I went on duty.
This was supposed to be planned and thought through, but what do you do instead? You go straight up the road and get the first thing you set eyes on. You've got a prisoner, yeah? The minute you're free, I want this sorted out. Everything here, all this, goes back to where you got it from.
Sir.
I'm sorry, Reg, but it's only been 3 hours and already it's a complete cock-up. It all goes back. The garden is on hold.
The Peugeot engine, okay? The one I put in Franklin's car. I didn't steal it, but, well, I knew it was probably stolen.
Who by? Fella over in Greenwich.
Forget him, I made him up. I got it somewhere local.
What about the bits on the Porsche? Were they for one of your customers?
No. They're in my workshops because the blokes who do me favours with spare parts wanted a favour in return, a place to hide them for a couple of days.
Then what?
Then, I don't know, another safe place. Eventually, this is how the scam goes. The insurance company recovers the chassis from wherever it was dumped.
Derelict factory.
They take one look at it, write it off, put it up for sale. The blokes I know put in a good bid for it, buy it, stick back in everything they took out from it, give it a good old polish and sell it through the trade to some complete sucker.
You're going to give us some names?
Don't think I can.
You wouldn't be messing about with stolen parts if it wasn't for them. You've been nicked. Your livelihood's about to disappear, and yet you're still prepared to protect them. That's stupid.
All right.
Well, it is, isn't it? Unless you're working with them, of course.
I'm not working for anyone.
It sounds like you are.
I'm not.
Then what's your problem?
The bloke's called Jack Marley. He runs a breaker's yard.
And, I'm going to want a refund. Yeah, no, but look, I'll come in and, you know, talk to you about this. And also, there was a problem here. A couple of the shrubs got damaged and one of the tubs was broken. But I'll pay for those myself. Yeah. Well, as far as I can make out, everything else survived. Yeah. Yeah, no, but like I say, I'll come in and I'll talk to you about that, yeah. Thank you, Mr. Burgess.
Refund for things you didn't pay for. I thought you were king of the mumpers. Well, look, if you're throwing money around, how much would you give me? Keeping quiet about it. Come on, Mike and Gary want to move on Marley before he goes home for the day.